السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما وعملا متقبلا يا أرحم الراحمين. We meet again tonight with Sheikh Asmat Akhchan, our visiting Sheikh from Florida, Greater Miami. He is, inshallah, our potential imam. He is here to give us a lecture. Inshallah, today's khutbah is about the will in Islam, al-wasiyah in Islam. And we will have about a half an hour, inshallah, towards the end for questions and answers. We will be passing around the cards for anybody that wants to write a question. We will be more than happy, inshallah, to take these questions. I believe everybody here knows Sheikh Asmat. This is his second visit to the community. But for the ones that don't know him yet, Sheikh Asmat graduated from Al-Azhar University in Egypt, and he's occupied the position of an imam in multiple masjids, including New York and Greater Miami here in the States, in addition to Malaysia, Egypt, and in Texas here too. Inshallah, he's applied for a position of imam here, and he is visiting with us, so he gets to know us and we get to know him. And tonight's khutbah, inshallah, will be about the will of Islam. I will hand the mic to him, and please have your questions ready towards the end.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسولنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. When I hold the microphone, sometimes I forget the time. We have limited time, half hour. Of course, it's very little for me to warm up. So that's why I have to focus on my notes so I can finish everything, inshallah. And after the lecture, so if there is any questions, inshallah, we try to answer. باب الوصايا. Wills bequest. What does it mean, الوصايا? الوصايا is the plural of وصية. Just وصية is wills. Let us start the وصية of Ibrahim عليه السلام. Because every prophet had wasiyya. What was his wasiyya? The Quran says, وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُبُ. What was the wasiyya that he gave to his children? Previous ayah says, إِذْ قَالَ لَهُ رَبُّهُ أَسْلِمْ قَالَ أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُبُ يَا بَنِيهِ. The wasiyya is this, the will of Ibrahim عليه السلام. إن الله اصطفى لكم الدين فلا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. I'm leaving you وصية that don't die after me except as Muslims. And Allah has chosen for you the Islam as religion that you must follow. And also Yaqub عليه السلام gave same وصية to his children. What he said, أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءَ إِذْ حَضَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتُ إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِ قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَهَكَ وَإِلَهَ آبَائِكَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَاعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا. What you are going to worship after my death? They told him, we are going to worship one إله. We submitted to one إله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the ilah of our grandfather Ibrahim and his children Ismail and Ishaq, and your ilah, ilah wahda. The wasiyah that we are talking here is a little bit different wasiyah. It has something to do with inheritance. It is not, of course, mirath, it is wasiyah. We are trying to understand what is the difference between al-wasiyah and inheritance. The wills or the bequests have al-musi, testator who has the wealth, who wants to give away from his wealth, not everything, but part of his wealth. He called al-Musi. And then we have wasi. Wasi as the trustee, who will receive the wasiya or al-musala. Wasi receive the wasi given to the musala. The one could be same person. The wasi who gonna receive it could be wasi himself, or he could be right like a messenger between guardian, between al-musi wa al-musala, between the testator and musala, the one who gonna receive the wasiya, who gonna use it. He called also a trustee or guardian. Brothers, the wasiya is, the will is مشروع in Quran, in Sunnah, in Ijma'. What does it mean? Allah talk about al-wasiya request in the Quran. And Rasulullah spoke about this in Hadith, and then all the scholars, the Ummah, the scholars, they ijma' agreement that wasi is mashru, the will is mashru, it is valid in Islam. There is something which called wasi valid because sometimes it's obligatory for you to do it, sometimes it's haram for you to do it, sometimes it's makruh for you to do it, sometimes it's mubah, sometimes it's mustahab. Now, what the Quran says about the wasi, the wills? قال الله تعالى كتب عليكم إذا حضر أحدكم الموت إن ترك خيرا الوصية للوالدين والأقربين بالمعروف حقا على المتقين. Very important to know this ayah is منسوخ, which is obligated حكما, but it is ayah, it is valid. We recite it, we believe in it, but it is mansukh. Which ayah obligated? The obligator is al-nasikh, Surah al-Nisa. يُوصِيكُمُ اللَّهُ فِي أَوْلَادِكُمْ لِلذَّكَرِ مِثْلُ حَظْرِ الْأُنْثَيَيْنِ. Because this wasiyah, this ayah, talks about all your wealth, properties. Before you die, you give it to your parents and to your relatives. This was the first ayah. And then the second, which was the nasikh, which was the obligator for this ayah is يُوصِيكُمْ اللَّهُ فِي أَوْلَادِكُمْ لِلذَّكَرِ مِثْلُ حَظْرِ الْأُنْثَيَيْنِ. But this is not mansukh. Al-wasiyyatu, a thuluth from your property, one third of your property to give, to will away, it is not mansukh, it is not obligated, it is valid until day of judgment. Is this clear? So the part which says you have to give, not you have to give. If you want to give, you can, you are allowed to give up to one third of your property, not more than that. Illa an yujizuha al-waratha. Except when the inheritors, they agree you can give more than that. Just, we have to understand. The Quran says, فَمَنْ بَدَّلَهُ بَعْدَمَا سَمِعَهُ فَإِنَّمَا إِثْمُهُ عَلَى الَّذِينَ يُبَدِّنَا. If somebody after he heard this, he agreed upon this, and he changed the wasiyah, the will,
translation,
he changed the will, he changed it after the testator, he died, he lied. He said, oh, he didn't leave 1 million, he lived only half. Allah said, Allah will punish that person. He is big sinner by changing this. فَمَنْ خَافَ مِنْ مُوصٍ جَنَفًا أَوْ إِثْمًا. جَنَف means here ظُلْ أَوْ إِثْمًا فَأَصْلَحَ بَيْنُهُ فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ. When the people from outside, they watch the whole case, the story, and they saw there is something wrong, ظُلْ, injustice, if they involve, Allah will reward them. So they have right to involve, to correct this. If they see, for example, This later he gave everything to his younger son. Or he gave everything to strangers. He didn't leave anything to his children. It is haram or halal? It is haram. Now, let us see, inshallah, one by one, quick, the details. Dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said, min ba'd, the surah Nisa, min ba'd, this is valid, nasir. Min ba'd, wasiyatin yusi biha awdain. After the payment of legacies, he may have bequest or debt. He have debt, for example, loan. Now, he wants to write will. Tell me, which one is first? Which one is more important? To write down, to pay his loan, or just give wasiyah to strangers, wills? We have to know. First, he have to write down, he had such and such loan, that loan must be paid after his death. Right or wrong? That's the wasiyah too. Then, if there is something left, then he can write the wasiyah, which is maximum one-third of his property. He can write this to be given to such and such. For example, for khairat. That's what Allah SWT said, in taraka khaira. This is very important, khaira. Good and khaba'ith, they are not khaira. For example, he earned this money from haram, he stole it from somebody, now he want to will. No, it's not khaira. Halal money he has, that is khaira. We have to understand this too. Dear brothers, what is the first condition for this? Now we're going to understand better what is wills. The scholars say, everybody agree that if he wants, he decided to write down his will, I mean to give his will, it is wajib for him to write it down. It is not enough only just to talk about it. You see? He must bring those conditions, witnesses, and such and such and so many conditions. When he decide to give away something, to bequeath something, then he must write it down. Otherwise, it will bring too much problem and fight after his death. Right or wrong? Everything should be clear. And there is hadith about the wasiyah. عن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ما حق امرئ مسلم له شيء يريد أن يوصي فيه يبيت ليلتين إلا ووصية مكتوبة عنده متفق عليه. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم It is the duty of a Muslim man who has something which is to be given as a bequest not to have it for two nights without having his will written regarding it. As muttafaqun alayh. So what does it mean? If you want to will something, then you have to write. If you don't want, you don't have to, unless it is loan. You owe something. Or it is something like hajj, you didn't do hajj. Niyabatan. You can find some wakil, somebody who can represent you, to write down that amount you have to give it to such a person to do hajj for me niyabatan in my place. I couldn't do it. Why? I was busy. Why? I was trying to make money, get rich and rich. Now I'm old man, I cannot do hajj. Look, brothers, what happened? There is a very rich man in New York. I will tell you something. My friends, they told me. In Long Island, he was from Turkey, but very, very wealthy man. He was married with a Christian lady. I mean, it is valid in Islam, you know. And what happened is, the person got sick, 60-something years old. Oh, the brothers, they went to visit.